Hello everyone and welcome in this new video tutorial of AnimalTA, and today we will see how to correct the trajectories obtained from the tracking. So first of all, in this video I will consider that you already have tracked videos. If it's not the case and that you have some difficulties to obtain tracked videos, I invite you to go to check the other videos from this channel. For today I will work with two different videos. The first one is a two choice test of two different fish, and the second video is pairs of spiders inside little arenas. So when you want to correct the trajectories of your targets, you will first select the video of interest and then press the view and correct track. So you arrive here in this panel, which should be a bit familiar for you because we have, like always, our video reader, our timeline, play and stop button, and we have some new options. You can also notice that now our targets are represented here. They have been tracked, so you can see where the program considers that their position is. And you have a little tail which indicates to you the last known position of these targets. A first thing you can do is to go to change the visual parameters here. The first one is the tail length. It's how much positions you want to display in your video. So if you increase it, you will show a longer tail, and if you decrease it, a shorter one. You can also change the color of the individuals. For instance, this red is quite visible, but my green here is not very easy to see, so I want to change it. To do that, I will just press in the color here and choose a new color. So I want, for instance, this purple here, which is much more visible. You can also change the name of your target. By default, AnimalTA always call your targets from individual 0 to individual n. So it will be individual 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Of course, this is not very clear for you later. In my case, I only have one individual per arena, so it's not very important. But if you have more than one individual per arena, it might be important to give a name to each of these individuals and a name that you can identify. So in my case, I will test that this fish is called fish number 2 because it's in the second tank. So I will call it fish 2. Don't forget to validate here. As you can see, my data are immediately changed and now it's called fish 2. Then I will do the same for this other fish, which I want to call fish 1. And do not forget to validate. The name that you give to your targets here is a name that will be used from this moment to the end of the AnimalTA's process to indicate which target you are working with. A last visual option you can use is a show all trajectories, which will just display everywhere that your target was localized. Then you have this big data table. It's quite simple. The first column is always a frame. As you can see, it's related to your timeline, so if I'm moving, my table is updated. And you have also one column for each individual. So this is a column of fish 2, and this is a column of fish 1. As you can see, when I select one individual or the other, it's indicated here in my table by these little stars. So the selected individual is the one that has the stars. To select an individual, you can either click on the individual here, or you can also click on the corresponding column in the table. And as you can see, both image and table are updated. You can also change a bit like this, maybe it's easier to see. The current displayed frame on the video is indicated on the table with this arrow here. It's also the line which is written in bold. So I can move through my video using either my timeline or directly in the table. To move through the table, you can use the mouse wheel. You can also use this scroll bar here in the right of the table. Then you have four different options around this table. The first one is the go to the next missing value. This is when AnimalTA doesn't find your target at all, it will indicate its position with a NA value. So if I press this button here, it will directly jump to the next frame at which my fish or one of my fish is missing. So in that case, it's this fish which is missing for all this duration. And what you can see that what happened is that this fish was very, very to the right of the arena. So my guess is that probably it was in fact outside of the arena I defined. So to correct this kind of problem, you have various options. The first option is to make a correction frame by frame. To do that, you will go in the problematic frame and in the problematic column. So here I'm in my first problematic frame. It's a good column that's selected, and I will just go in my image and click where I think my target is. So you can like always zoom in to be a bit more precise, and then you press right on the position of your target. So I consider my fish is here. The moment that I press right, the coordinate will be added in the table and the video will move from one frame forward, which means that I can just do like this, right click in each frame, making the process a bit faster. But well, it's still not very, very fast. So another option that you have instead of doing frame by frame is to ask the program to redo this part of the tracking with other parameters. So I will take my problematic part, which should begin around here, and I will select all the problematic part of my table. To select, you just hold the shift button and just click in the new frame, and all that's appearing blue is now selected. Once you selected the problematic part, you can press the redo tracking option. This will open a new window, and in this window, so you have here the same like always, but this time you have a sub sample of your video, which is only this part you selected. And you can change all the parameters that we set before. So in my case, I told you that it comes from this arena, which is a bit small. So I will press my change arena button, and I will tell that for only for this little part of the video, I will consider that my arena is a bit bigger. So I validate, and now I can press the redo the tracking button. And now I can see the results for this part of the video, and as you can see, my fish is not lost anymore. In this case, it was a problem coming from the size of the arena, but you can change any kind of the parameters. So you can, for instance, change the background. You can also change the parameters of the tracking. You could change the threshold value. Well, anything that you prepared before can be changed for a small portion of the video. Once you are happy with the new track, you just validate this change and your data will be immediately updated. So as you can see here now, I have a correct track for all this period. Well, this is good when you can actually do the track, but sometimes it's not the case, and I will show you. So we will go to the next missing value. I have a little problem with this video because during a good part of the time, my fish was not visible at all. In that case, you have several options. The first option and the easiest one is just to tell that, well, you keep the NA value. It's not a problem to have NA value. It just means that you don't know where the fish is during this period and you don't want to infer about its position. But well, in my case, for instance, I'm quite sure that during this short period of time, my fish was moving like this. I can just press where I think the fish is and just change the coordinates manually, but it can take a bit of time. Another option is to simply again select the problematic period. This time it's important that I have at the beginning and the end known value, and then press the interpolate button. Interpolation is just that the program will calculate where your fish would be if it was moving at a constant speed and in a straight line during the first and the last selected image. So it will just make a straight line between my two points. You can always correct the position of an individual just by moving the point. and the coordinates on the table are immediately updated. So this can be useful for a very punctual correction of the coordinates. If you have also some very long and problematic part of your video, you can always select and remove yourself the coordinates. So imagine I'm not happy with my interpolation because I don't like what I did here at the beginning. So I will go from here to this moment. So I select again with my shift key on the keyboard and then press the remove the coordinates. And the computer will replace all the selected coordinates by NA, which now allow me to make a new correction again. This seems much better. Now that we corrected everything, as you can see, AnimalTA is telling us that we don't have any more missing values. So this can be useful if you want to check your videos. At the moment that this button here is green, it means that you don't have any value in your table. One thing you can also do is to check your tracking at an accelerated pace. So for instance, I will just play my video and I can accelerate it very strongly the speed. And like this, you can have, this is for instance a 10 minutes video, and you can have a look at the whole tracking in a few seconds only. Now, let's continue. This video is finished, so I will validate here and I can begin with my next video. As you can see now that I finished here, my button changed and is now blue. If I go for my second video, in this second video we don't have any missing value, as you can see here. We have seems to be a quite good tracking, but there is one problem which is particularly clear if you look at this arena. As you can see, we have two spiders. I will change the color of that one for something a bit more visible. Okay, so we have our yellow spider here and our green spider. And this yellow spider is moving, but at a moment she will walk on the top of the green one and continue. And at this moment, the program is confused and he is unable to keep the identity of the targets. He considered that my yellow target is in fact the green and that my green is in fact the yellow. So to fix this problem and tell the program that he is wrong, what you need to do is to identify the problematic moment. So I get that this is more or less a moment at which my identity should be swapped. So I will select my first individual, then hold the shift key and select the other one. And at the moment that you do that, the identities of the two spiders will be swapped from this moment until the end of the video. So now, as you can see, the problem is fixed. I think it happened again a bit later. So indeed, here we have again the same problem. So we will just use the exact same technique to correct that problem and tell him that these two are like this, and he will fix the trajectories. So you can do that as much as you want. Of course, you have to be careful. You have to process in order, because if you swap the identities in the end of the video and after in the beginning, well, everything will be swapped each time. So always proceed from the beginning of the video toward the end. And I think that's all. We saw all the possibilities to correct the tracking data. So thank you very much for your attention, and I hope to see you for the next video tutorial. Have a nice day!